There are many kinds of vaccines and many ways to manufacture them. Vaccines take an average of 10 years from research in the lab to administering them in the doctor's office. This timeline must be shortened if we want to be prepared for pandemics or novel diseases as they emerge. Why do traditional vaccines take so long? Well, it's the process for developing and testing them. All pathogens that cause infectious diseases like viruses have an associated antigen. This antigen activates our immune system to fight that virus. Scientists must identify the right antigen, find a way to produce mass quantities of it, and then integrate it into a vaccine. It's a long process. Antigens are usually proteins, and human cells are constantly making proteins as building blocks to maintain our bodies. So scientists asked the question, what if we could program our own cells to make these antigens and trigger the same immune response as traditional vaccines? This is the goal of mRNA vaccines. mRNA, or messenger RNA, is the code that tells our cells which protein to make. And thanks to recent advances in DNA sequencing, scientists can quickly identify the code to make the antigen protein specific to the disease we want to fight and build the mRNA in the lab. The mRNA vaccine delivers this code, not a form of the pathogen or antigen, to tell our cells to produce the antigen. Once the antigen is present in our bodies, it initiates an immune response, just as a traditional vaccine would. The good news is that mRNA are much simpler to produce in the lab than proteins. To create the synthesized mRNA, scientists insert the sequence corresponding to the mRNA into a plasmid, a small DNA molecule within a cell that can replicate itself. This plasmid is put into a reactor where an enzymatic reaction triggers the synthesis of the mRNA. The synthesized mRNA is then purified and encapsulated in a lipid nanoparticle. The lipid coating enables the mRNA to reach our cells where protein production takes place, triggering the immune response. This process can be used to produce many different mRNA by just changing the sequence inserted in the DNA plasmid. Scientists have great confidence in the potential of mRNA vaccines, not just for the prevention of infectious diseases, but also in the treatment of cancer and perhaps even allergies. To summarize, mRNA vaccines will offer many benefits over traditional vaccine manufacturing. Speed. They don't require the slow process of producing antigens by cell culture or bacterial fermentation in a lab. They simply signal our bodies to produce the antigen ourselves. Savings. The same production setup can be used for multiple vaccines, reducing costs significantly, unlike traditional vaccines which require dedicated facilities for each kind of vaccine. mRNA vaccines are not common today, but have tremendous potential and could alter how we think about vaccine development in the future. To learn more about the different vaccine development and manufacturing processes, visit sartorius.com/vaccines.